guys get, did they get naked when you did the production of hair?
Yeah, they did. And I, there was a...
Were you nude?
No, I wasn't. Because fuck that. You can, you could opt to be on the offstage mic. And
if you were uptight?
Yeah.
Or you had a small cock?
You know, if you have a small cock, they check your cock when you... That, right. It's a passport thing.
Well, aren't you announcing to the world when you say, I'm going to be... When you're one
I'm
of the dudes...
Mic. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you're a dude... And there's hot chicks mincing around on stage naked.
Right.
And you go, I'll be over here behind the duvetine. You're just saying small cock, right?
No, I know. I know. But, you know, my safety was that I got hired as an understudy in the beginning. So I was, all the understudies were on the offstage mic.
Oh, okay.
And then when I got promoted up to one of the parts, I technically could have, you know, stepped out. But by then I could blame it on like, no, it's a good break. I just get to sit in the chair and.
Right, right.
Also, you could blame it on the love handles and just be like, no, no, it's, you know, I don't want to fucking...
So did they have two mics? Did they have understudy mic and small cock mic back
there? Was
there?
A small cock mic, and yeah.
So how many people
dude,
were naked on
huge.
Stage?
My
oh,
cock
oh
really
you do have
huge.
A huge cock?
Yeah, yeah, it's crazy. Oh. It'll knock you out.
Wow. So you have...
I swear to God, I told my wife, I was like, oh, in within 10 minutes, I'll be talking about... My dick, and he'll start a masturbation story. Like you've
no,
already,
I won't.
We already covered it.
I won't.
All right,
but you
good.
Do have a you have a large cock?
It's yeah, it's pretty. It's all right. No, I don't think so. You'll find out. I gotta go.
it's briny tasting. I know that, but it was dark, so I never actually saw it.
Was that a shrimp joke?
The no.
Oh, all right.
So you, how many people would be naked on stage?
I don't remember. They were like, I mean. Probably 16 people. In the
were there some hot chicks?
Oh, yeah.
And they would be totally naked?
Totally naked.
When, and no pasties, one... no dance panties, nothing. Just totally naked running
around
on
stage?
No, they
would just get naked. And everyone wears like, they're called dashikis or, you know,
right.
Some tribal thing, whatever. So all the guys literally would be like doing the helicopter move to, you
right.
know, fluff it up.
Sure.
Underneath, there'd be a lot of dashiki. They'd turn upstage and fluff up their... Wieners.
Well,
then,
I mean, the whole thing about showing off your joint is it's a real fine line between you can't go out there with a full blown boner,
no,
because that makes you weirdo,
right?
But if you go out there with the you know just stepped out of the shower, whatever kind of vibe, like I always liken it to the actor who rattles a couple push ups off before he goes out in a tank top.
Right.
It's not a full-blown workout, but he does 20 push-ups just to get a little blood
to
flowing.
To get the vein going.
Just get the vein going.
That one.
Right?
Yeah. I've never seen that one vein in my arm.
I've never seen one in my arm either. Yeah. But that's what happens. You got to get a little helicopter going
the
shiki.
I wouldn't know because I was off in the small cock mic. But, yeah.
Now, and so it must have been good. Like, you must have had a crush on some of the chicks.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. I mean, they were all... There was one girl who actually... was standing there doing, and I had a side view of everyone while they were doing the song.
Right.
From the offstage, and literally out of her little vagina was coming a tampon string just sticking out like the mast of a ship.
It was, wow. Yeah.
That's crazy.
That's a dedication to your craft.
Yeah.
You know,
Adam, you would have got a hell of a lot of whacking material out of course
yeah,
like that.
I know. The whole thing about, think about the tampon string. Let me just say this. I never thought about this, but the tampon string should not be white. It should be flesh-colored.
Or you should get it based on the color of your hair.
Yeah. Or, well, right? not even your hair, the color of your leg. Like,
well,
if,
I don't
if
think it hangs down low. I think it just...
Sometimes it does.
Well, that means you have a shallow vagina.
No, you don't take the string and wedge it up there.
No. Let me
Do
show
you?
You. Let me show you.
Yeah. How does that work?
I test this out of my ass so I can show you. No. I don't know.
No,
I think
no. You put the tampon up there.
But I don't think
and
it
then
hangs like a
Well,
rope,
look,
like
I mean, you take it and throw it over your shoulder, you tuck it up, you do whatever you got it. You do what you do. You know what you do? It's like when you have a belt and you have that extra 8 inches of belt.
I've never had that.
Okay. Right. Well, let's say you were not morbidly obese. Jesus. No. When you put a belt on and you have that extra 8 inches of belt flopping around, you don't just flop it out. You kind of tuck it in a little.
Yeah.
But
sure.
You don't shove it up your ass. It's still there. I'm saying,
yeah.
No, I've seen chicks with the tampon string hanging down. That's how they get hold of it.
Well, yeah, but sometimes I guess hers was deeper, point, and it stuck out just a little.
The point is the tampon string should not be white. It pops too much.
But I think that's good for the lady to be able to locate it quickly.
I know, but what if she's at the beach and it pops out of her, you know, bathing suit? Or what if she's doing a production of hair and it falls right down next to her leg? The tampon string should be, it should be the color of your skin.
All right.
That's all I'm saying.
All right.
Listen.
I think the android should be the pubic hair color.
Yeah. But I don't think the string hangs. I don't think you take the string and shove it up your twat.
It would just look like a Rapunzel weave. You know what I mean?
It would just be hanging, though.
It's hanging, right?
Yeah.
Why should it be the color of your pubic hair if it's hanging 4 inches from your...
Well, if you're doing a musical, you're going to be able to camouflage it and still retrieve it when you want.
Now, this isn't for musicals. This is just in general. But it's going to look like you have a long 4-inch rogue pube.
You could braid it. What if there's a braid and it looks like Pocahontas?
No, listen. You know when they have...
You're relating this to the pimple medicine, because why is pimple medicine...
No, here's what I'm relating it to. All right, you ever see The Preachers?
No. What do you mean?
When a preacher, when they do those like Sunday morning guys are up there preaching.
Oh, yeah.
And they have, they're not holding the microphone. They have the headset thing.
Right.
That's got the little headset thing.
Time Life Operator thing.
Time Life Operator thing. That thing is always beige. And then the little windscreen on the end of it, the little foam thing, that's beige too. Because if you're more than five rows back, it kind of looks like you don't see the microphone. They make it the skin color. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So it doesn't show up. The same theory with the tampon string. Make it the color of your thigh. It hangs down.
All right.
I don't know if it hangs down, actually.
You have to...
Are you saying you think they tuck the string up their twat?
I can't believe you said
no. Wait, I think it hangs. Dan, what do you think?
You think it hangs, right?
Well, Dan was there. You saw it actually in action. What was it doing?
She was dancing. It could have popped out.
Well, actually, yeah, she was just doing... Like
the string hangs. It's a ripcord. And there's a secondary shoot called a maxi pad.
We could take some emails and see what people think.
I feel like it hangs.
I think, all right. This was sticking out betwixt the, you know.
But if it hangs, then it should be the color of your thigh, not the color of your pubes.
All right.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, because you don't want it to look like a
crazy... If it popped out of your bikini bottom, wouldn't you want it to be the color of your thigh?
No, because then it looks like you have some crazy...
No, you want it to be the color of your pube?
Or let's
Don,
stick with
don't
white.
Be an asshole.
I'm not an asshole because I have an opinion. I think it would hide it better.
You want it... If it popped out of your bikini bottom, you'd want it to look like a weird pube popped out of your bikini bottom?
Well, then why not make it white so it's very clear that it's a tampon string?
Because then everyone
we're full
knows
circle
you got a tampon
now.
In.
But we're all born because someone wore a tampon, right?
I never thought of it that way. I'm just saying, if it popped out of your bikini bottom, wouldn't you want the string to be the color of your thigh if you were lying down on the beach and the tampon and the string popped out of your bikini bottom? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, so shut the fuck up.
No, you're saying if the string lays on the leg, hiding it just like the skin-colored mic. If it's laying on the leg, yeah. But
right.
If it's swinging free, I think the pubic hair is a better way to go.
Well, you're not playing paddle ball. You're getting sun by lying down on your back on a chaise lounge. All
right.
That's all.
All right, Dan's here. Let's get back to Dan.
All right. Well, where am I? Anyway, Dan, so you're up on the thing. You're doing what? Now
you're cranky now. You're mad. Your
no, I'm just want to. Your tampon's popped out. You're
all
on
right.
A small dick mic behind the duvetine. What happened? I just want to know the rest of your stupid story.
Shit. God. Dude, this is... If you wrap this up at 36 minutes, that's when I know a fucking podcast blows.
We're going deep.
No, because sometimes I look down at my iPod and it says 36 minutes. I'm like, you fucking hated this person.
No.
That you wrap it up.
No,
soon.
We got a lot of ground to cover.
I mean, you don't have to go 55, but I
no, we'll go 55.
It's got to
we'll go
past 36.
Or, go ahead, Dan.
Yeah. So I don't know. Well, I did hair. Then I moved to New York City. I did that for a year. Moved to New York City and was like a waiter at a stupid restaurant. And,
right. The typical stuff.
Yeah, the shit you're supposed
to
do.
And what? Did you major in theater at Emerson?
Yeah, I did. I majored in acting and TV production. It was so lame. And then,
and so you knew you
why'd
could
you
sing.
Why did you laugh when I said
that? Well, no, it's the way you said acting.
Oh, all right. All right, good.
It was something a funny comedic actor would do.
Oh, good. All right.
Brought a smile to my face.
Thanks.
So we should wrap this up, actually. It's been 21 minutes. So, no, we're going deep.
All right. Yeah.
So... You're New York. you're working